Hi guys, I have a lower body workout for us today. So for the lower body workout, we're gonna grab a box for our prop today. We're gonna start with footwork just to really warm up the legs, and then after that we'll be on the box. I'm gonna start with my springs fully loaded. Again, it is going to be like a heavy leg day. Feel free if you guys don't wanna go fully loaded, you can go heavy and a light, heavy and a medium spring. It is up to you. Before we get started, as always, do not forget to like, share, and subscribe to my channel, you guys. Again, it is the best way to support the holistic movement Pilates. Thank you guys. Let's go ahead and get started lying down. My footbar is up at the starting position. Again, I am fully loaded with my springs today. You guys do not need to go fully loaded if you don't want to. We're gonna start with our heels on the footbar, parallel with each other. Headrest can be up or down. Personal preference, that is up to you guys. I like mine up. And then arms are at my side. I'm in my neutral spine, so I have that nice natural curvature for my low back. We are going to go ahead and we're going to exhale to push out today. We're going to inhale to come in. So let's exhale to press carriage way. Inhale back. Exhale out. Inhale back. Now, again, heavy. I usually do not do leg heavy. I'm usually more of an abdominal girl, but let's go light today. Push. And pull. I want you guys to resist those springs as you come in. And we're exhaling out today. Inhaling in. We're going to go for 3, 2. On this last one, I'm going to hold out from here. I'm going to go halfway with my carriage, all the way out. Halfway in, all the way out for halfway pulses. 4, 3, 2, and 1. I'm going to hold halfway and little pulses of our carriage for 8, 7, 6, 5, 2, 1, all the way out, and then right back in. All right, same thing with those arches on. Again, they're sit bones distance away. We're gonna exhale, push, inhale, resist. Push out, resist in. You guys, I wanna thank, as always, my pelvis is staying nice and still. My sacrum is heavy. I am as evenly weighted throughout my right and my left side of the body as I can get myself. Push, resist, push, resist for 3, 2, 1, ready, halfway in, all the way out, halfway in, all the way out for those halfway pulses. Should feel those quads burning. 3, 2, 1, halfway, little pulses of the carriage for 8. 3, 2, 1, work all the way out, all the way back in. All right, let's go toes, balls of our feet onto the bar. All 10 toes should be on. Again, we're gonna exhale to push, inhale in, exhale out, inhale back, out. Ooh, my quads are really feeling this. 4, 3, 2, 1, ready, halfway pulses, halfway in, out, halfway in, out. 4, 3, 2, 1, hold halfway, little pulses for 8. 4, 3, 2, 1, we're all the way out, all the way back in. All right, last set for a warm-up, heels are on. Slide them all the way up to side so you guys are right into your wide second position. I'm exhaling to push right back out. And I'm inhaling to come right back in. In my wide second, I want to think I'm pushing from my heels and I'm squeezing my glutes so I can get that glute max to fire. Three more. Which is one blue spring on the dance bar. body reformer. So one medium, one blue if you guys are in balance body. We are going to keep our foot bars where they're at. Grab your box. And then go ahead, put your box on. Feel free to go in front of your shoulder blocks with the box today, guys. And then my headrest is going to go all the way down. Now, we're gonna kneel on our boxes. We are facing these straps. Hands are on the two front corners of the box. And then I'm gonna grab my right strap. When I grab my strap, it's easy to grab where your rope connects to the loop. You're gonna pull in, and then the long loop is gonna go onto the arch of that right foot. Now, when I'm here, my shoulders over my hands, my hips are right over my knees. I'm stabilizing from my shoulders and my core, and I'm gonna exhale to kick my right leg back and tilt the up, and then I'm gonna inhale right back in. Press a little lift of the leg, inhale back. I wanna feel my glute max and hamstring really kicking in to lift the leg up. Press to the lift and bend. Three more. Okay, now this last one, we're gonna hold our leg out away from us. I'm gonna bring my leg slightly out to the right side. It's gonna go down to the floor to the outside frame of the carriage. I'm gonna kick my leg back. So down to the floor, my foot traces the frame of my carriage when I lower, and I'm kicking back. Now, ideally, when my leg goes down, my pelvis is staying in the same place as I lower, same place as I lift. It's staying parallel with the floor. My eyes are looking down to the floor, and I want to feel my obliques kicking in here to help stabilize me. Last one, down. And up. Now we're gonna keep the leg kicked back in line with the body. We're flexing the foot, keep the leg straight. Little circles of our leg. Think like dinner plate size circles. Keep the foot flexed, keep the leg lifted. Four, three, two, one, and then we'll relax. Okay, from here you guys, keep the strap on your foot. You're gonna sit on your left hip. And then your left forearm is gonna go into your headrest. Both knees are gonna be bent at a 90 degree angle, and most of my body weight should be supported here by the box. So if your ribs are off, scoot your butts down so you're supported. Now, if you need to support your head, bend your elbow. You can always take your head into your hand. Otherwise, stay with your forearm down. Hips are stacked, shoulders are stacked. Top leg lifts hip distance. We're gonna kick our leg out one time, and we're gonna hold it out here. Now, on an inhale, we're gonna kick our leg forward, and we're gonna exhale, kick back. Inhale forward, and exhale, kick back. We want that glute max, again, to fire, hamstring to fire as we kick. Inhale forward, exhale back. Now, as I kick forward, my leg is not dipping down to the floor. It stays right in line with my hip as I go forward. Use that glute to kick back. Let's do two. And then last one. Now when we kick back, we're gonna hold our leg back here. Hips stay stacked. We're gonna bring the leg up to the ceiling, out in front of us, press back for a circle. Up, out in front, press back. Up, out in front, press back. We have two, and then last one. Now when we kick back, hold, reverse that circle, forward, up, pull down, forward, up, pull the leg down. One more challenging in this direction. Give me two, and then last one. All right, now we're gonna bend that top leg. The strap is going to go all the way up to our thigh, so it's right above the knee. Both knees are gonna be bent at a 90, hips are still stacked, shoulders are still stacked. Now, without my carriage moving, I'm gonna lift my top leg off of my bottom leg, and I'm gonna lower down. Lift the top leg, abduction, lower down. So we should feel the outside of the leg into the outside of the glutes firing up. So lift, lower, lift, lower. So right into those stabilizers. We have three, two, and one. All right, now relax that leg down. We're going to use our left hand into our headrest. We're going to sit up. Our butts are going to go into the box. And we're going to slide the strap to our ankle. Okay, now when you guys get it to your ankle, you are going to start with your right leg just slightly lifted up off the box. It's still bent at a 90 degree angle. And then from here, we're going to pull our leg towards the bar and we're going to come back. Now, when I open my leg out to the side, my knee and my ankle are staying in line with each other. And then again, my pelvis is not shifting. So my hips are staying parallel to the wall out in front of me. We're back into that abduction. We're opening out to the side, returning, open, return. We have 4, 3. All right, last one. Now the next time our knee ends up right in front of our hip, we're gonna hold it here. We're gonna lift the right leg up and down, up and down. The carriage does not move. We're just lifting the leg, lifting, lowering, and again, it stays bent at that 90 degree angle. We should feel our quad and our hip flexor firing up here. We have 3, 2, 1, relax that leg. Okay, we'll take that strap off of our foot. We're gonna hang it back up onto the peg, back onto our hands and our knees. We're gonna grab the left strap this time. Again, it is easiest when you guys grab where the rope connects to the loop. Pull in, long loop goes onto the arch of your foot, shoulders over your hands, hips are right over my knees. Again, I'm stabilizing from my shoulders and my core. I'm gonna exhale and kick my my left leg back and up, bend in. Rest a little lift of that leg, bend. Again, quad, hamstring, glute max, leg day. Exhale, press little lift, inhale back. We have 3 more. All right, now this last one, we're gonna hold our leg back, bring it slightly out to the left side, go down to the floor to the outside from the carriage, kick that leg back. Again, when I lower my leg, my pelvis is ideally staying in that same spot. My hip does not drop down as my leg lowers. Inhale down, exhale lift. I want you guys to feel those obliques working to lower. Glute max, hamstring working to lift. Give me 1 more, and on this one, we're gonna hold that leg back. Keep it in line with the body. Flex the foot, the leg stays long, the foot is flexed. Little circles, that leg needs to stay lifted up. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, bend. Okay, sit on the right hip this time. Right forearm goes into your headrest. Both knees should be bent at the 90. Again, your body, guys, should be almost fully supported by this box. And then if you need to support your head, bend your elbow, take your head into your hand. All right, my top leg is gonna lift hip distance. I'm gonna push my leg out one time, hold. On my inhale, I'm gonna kick my leg forward. Exhale, kick back. Inhale forward, exhale, kick that leg back. My hips, my shoulders are staying stacked. Inhale, and exhale, kick. Forward, and back. Let's do 3, 2. All right, now this last one, let's hold the leg back. Ready, go up to the ceiling, out in front, press back. Up, out in front, press back. Those hips need to stay stacked. The movement comes right from the head of the femur in that hip socket. Last one. All right, now when we kick back, hold, reverse, kick forward, up, hold down, forward, up, hold down, a little more challenging. We have 3, 2 more, and then ready, last one. All right, bend that knee, strap goes around your leg, right above the knee, right on the thigh, hips are still stacked, carriage stays nice and still. We are going to lift the top leg and lower, lift and lower, working right into those abductors. Up and down, up and down. Three, two, last one. All right, now use that right hand, sit yourselves up, and then when you guys sit up, strap goes to your ankle. We are going to sit on our boxes. You are going to keep your knee bent at that 90. The left leg lifts slightly above the box. We're exhaling to pull the leg out to the side. Inhale back, exhale, pull it to the side. Inhale back, so we're back into that abduction. Don't worry, we will do adduction when we get those straps on your feet. Exhale to pull out, inhale back. Give me three more. Again, pelvis should be staying nice and still. Last one. Now, finish with that knee right in front of your hip. Ready? Lift and lower. Lift and lower that leg. So we're getting right into that quad hip flexor. Carriage does not move here, you guys. You have four more. Three, two, one, and you're done with those. Okay, take those straps off. Hang them on up. And then we're going to go ahead and we'll take our boxes off. Set them to the sides. Okay, we're going into some feet and straps. Since it's leg day, we are going heavy. So we're going to go two heavy springs with our way, two reds, and then I'm going to add on one of my light springs as well, so a yellow. So I have two heavies and a light, two reds, and a yellow. If you guys are on the same balance body reformer as me, remember that there is that second row that you can clip your springs onto. Feel free to hook to the second row if you like it a little heavier. We're gonna lie down and then head rest up or down. Again, that is up to you guys. Long loops, we're gonna grab, we're gonna push out, and then we're gonna take our straps onto our feet. Now, when we get our feet into our straps, we're gonna start in our Pilates stance, so our heels are together, toes are turned apart, and I'm just going to exhale and lower my legs straight down towards my springs, and I'm gonna inhale, hinge. Now, as always, when I lower my legs, I want my bra line to stay heavy. I'm engaging my core so that 2 inches underneath my belly bone is running in and up as I pull down. Inhale, hinge. My tailbone and my sacrum are staying heavy as my legs go up. All right, now the next time I lower my legs, I'm gonna pause down, still in my Pilates stance, so heels are together, toes are turned apart. I'm gonna inhale, open my legs out to the side of the room, stay in the same plane, bring the heels together. Open and close, inhale, open, exhale, close. Again, I'm trying to stay in that same plane the entire time. Adductors. Two more, and then last one. All right, now when we bring them together, we're gonna pause. We're gonna do 5 circles in each direction in our external rotation. So my heels are together, my toes are turned apart. I'm gonna lower my legs a little further down, open them wide out to the side, circle around and back up. Heels together, toes apart. Down, circle around, and up. Two more. And then last circle, down, or no, not. Now when I come up, I'm gonna pause, still my external rotation. Open my legs wide, press them down and around, zip them together, hinge up for 4 more. Again, I'm keeping myself in my external rotation the entire time, and then last one. All right, now when we come up, we're gonna pause, internally rotate. So toes are together, heels are turned apart. We're gonna exhale to lower the legs down, inhale, hinge. So we're just going straight down and up in our internal rotation for 3 more. Again, my bra line is staying down when my legs go down. My sacrum is staying down when my legs come up. Now, the next time the legs lower, pause with the legs down. We're gonna inhale, open the legs up to the sides. Make sure you're still in your internal rotation. Exhale, toes together. Inhale, open. Exhale, close. So my toes are staying pointed towards each other the entire time so I can get my adductors again to fire. Three,
two, and then last one. Now, same the internal rotation, we're gonna open the legs right back up to the side room. We're circling around back up. We have five circles in each direction in that internal, also known as that medial rotation. Two, and then last one. Now when I come up, I'm gonna pause, reverse. Two more, and then last one. All right, when we come up, low back can be flat, my feet are parallel with each other. I'm gonna take my right leg, I'm gonna bend my knee, and it's gonna go down to the floor, and I'm just gonna try to relax this right leg as much as I can. I'm gonna allow my left leg just to open out to the side of the room, just to give hip flexors, quads, abductors and hamstrings a nice stretch. We're just going to take a few deep inhales through the nose and exhale through the mouth. A couple more. And then last inhale and exhale. And then the left leg can come right back up. We'll fish our right foot back up. And then I'm going to bend my left knee. I'm going to send that leg down, open my right leg to the side, let my strap kind of adjust on my left foot. Try to surrender as much as you can into that stretch. Get as little tension out of your body as possible, or as much tension out of your body. So we want little tension in our muscles. Sides, left ankle, right knee. Feel free to keep your foot on the foot bar, otherwise you can hug your right knee in. And we should just get a nice big stretch in that left piriformis, right in the outside part of your glutes. All right, then we can untangle ourselves. We can sit up off of our reformers. You guys are all done with your leg workout. I hope you enjoyed it. Again, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to support my channel. Thanks, guys.